you know, from a kid who's joined our team this summer and really has battled and competed and won the job, and then he's held on to the job all through the season. You know, the only downfall Greg's had has been a couple extra points along the way, but you know, he's really been very efficient in the field goal area, and that's really what we've needed.
What do you think happened with those extra points?
We've looked at it, and I can only relate to like a 3-foot putt, and some of the best golfers miss some of those. You know, and but Greg's, I have all the confidence in the world that he can do the job, and just really excited to watch him play.
Andy Teasdall obviously got a lot of attention for what happened in the ACC Championship.
Right.
What do you think happened there?
A couple things. He's into the game. He sees an opening. He probably didn't realize what the down and distance was at that juncture. But, he has something that flashes in front of his face, and he pulls it down and makes a decision. He's going to try to run it, you know. One of the best things Andy is, he's a team guy, you know, and he's just trying to do his best, and it didn't work out. And, he'll learn from it and be better the next time.
Obviously, Dabo got some attention kind of for the way he was talking on the sideline. What did you tell Andy after that play?
You know, my biggest thing to him was, hey, we're going to need you to rest the game. You know, it happened early. You know, it's, hey, we're going to need you to punt second half. And he came back second half, and he punted real well for us. Probably had one of his better punts of the year. He had a 50-yarder in the second half. So my thing was get on the next play.
Did you feel like that was something you'd worked on with fake punt runs, or was that just kind of?
No, we haven't worked on that one in particular. Just something he did.
From the season as a whole, how well do you feel Andy's done?
I think Andy's done a good job. You know, he filled in for Bradley Pinion last year. That it left us early. I think he's done a good job.
Are there specific things you've worked on with him, with any of the guys, just to get better in these bowl practices?
Yes. You know, a lot of just technique work, especially dealing in the environments we're in. We're outdoors here, and, the wind could easily be a factor here Thursday afternoon. Those things, getting used to it this week while we've been down here.
Jim Brown, long snapper. How well has he done just filling that role?
You know, Jim stepped right up. We that was another job that was in question after last season's team was that position, and Jim's done a good job as well.
Dorian O'Daniel's another guy who seems to just have a lot of special teams talent.
Yeah.
How crucial has he been in that regard?
You know, he's done a great job. I'd say he's probably been our special teams leader. He's been on kickoff return. He's on our punt team. He's on our punt return team. He's on all four core as far as what we call units, and he's done a good job.
Is that a guy who you really see relish the opportunity?
Yes, I do. You know, I really do. He's done a good job, and I would probably say he's been our special team leader.
From a tight end, so Jordan Leggett, just the type of season he's had, you know, how pleased have you been with his
development? Yeah, really pleased with Jordan. You know, just his whole development as far as not only his play, but just as a person. You know, really maturing right before your eyes. He's done a good job. He's taken hold of not only himself, but a more of a leadership role. He's been a common factor for the offense. He's been a consistent player. He's worked on some of the things that he's needed to work on from a blocking standpoint. He's always been an efficient route runner. He's been a really a clutch guy in third down opportunities for him this year. And he's made some big catches over the year for us.